the name of the Lord. Just appreciate him. Glorify him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for day number one up to this 15 days of waiting on him. Thank you. Thank you. For day number one, thank you for week one. Thank you for week two. Thank you for this third week. Thank you for this 15th day. We are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful. God said, I should tell somebody, I will wipe away your tears. Thank you, Lord. God said, I should tell somebody, the insect that is behind the devouring manifestation shall be exposed. Amen. And all the exposed shall be destroyed. God said, I should tell somebody, the report that you got that had darkened your spirit is not your report. Hence, I am going to cause the one that I have given unto you to manifest, regardless of that report. God said, I should tell somebody, help commit to you. Help commit to you. I just want you to lift up your hand and just wave unto him. Just wave and tell him some sweet things. Tell him some lovely things. Ensure that you mean it. That's why it will make sense in the realm of the spirit. Thank you, Lord. Forever. Oh. Accept our thanks, but let this one surpass all those ones in the name of Jesus. Let the heaven over our head be open wider than ever before. Let there be a downpour of your blessing. We that are here and anyone that could be connected, that you have already consecrated for such person to connect from whatever nation or place that the person may be connecting from, reach out to all of us together. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Before you sit down, God just ministered to me that there is a particular family. I don't know whether that family is represented here. the work of the devil is increasingly manifesting in that family. We are going to be praying for that family. It could be your family. Maybe it's even my family that I'm not aware of. But we are going to use the corporate anointing to destroy the work of the devil increasingly manifesting in that family. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, in unity, we agree concerning that family that the work of the devil is increasingly manifesting. Destroy that work. Destroy that work. Destroy that work in the name of Jesus. Let that work of darkness be destroyed. Destroy that work. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, no, I'm just praying now. Let all works of the devil in all our family, or especially the family that you are mindful of right now, be totally destroyed. Let that be a reversal of anything that has gone wrong in the name of Jesus. And even between now and 2 days' time, let that be so much celebration in that family. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Put your hands together for Jesus. Please be seated. Results. Counseling insults. What did I say? Result. Counseling insult. You know one thing that you need to put forth in life when insults could be coming to you is to just have good results. You don't need to talk. They said that empty barrel is the one that wants. Make the loudest noise. You are not empty. You have the Holy Spirit. You are filled with the Holy Spirit. It's just for you to ask God to grant unto you good results. And all your mockers, all the ones that have been saying, where is your God? They will keep short. Results cancels insult. You know, when you read the book of Job, he went through so many things in the book of Job. There was a particular time that his friends, I think Job chapter 14, from 1 to 5, because our screen is a bit challenged, maybe I will read it here. Job 4. No, okay, Job 4. Okay, the screen is here. Job 4. Eliphaz, the Temanite, answered and said, if we assay to commune with thee, will thou be grieved? But who can withhold himself from speaking? You know, before we continue, can go with the scripture like that. The friends of Job, I think three of them, they came to him to comfort him. But by the time they will sit a bit, he has lost his children. He has lost his investment. It is well. But after a while, they started to think what they were thinking. Are we sure that this guy is safe? Is he yourself? Insults could become me sometimes when your result may not be in consonance with what people expect or what you may portray. Behold, thou hast instructed many, and thou hast strengthened the weak hand. Thy words are upholding him that was falling. They were telling Job like that. And thou hast strengthened the feeble knees. But now, it is come upon thee, and thou faintest. It touched thee, and thou art troubled. Anything that will make you helpless in this life, God will keep away from you. Amen. come to him. The rich man, helping to solve problems. And now a kind of problem that he did not even know, very complex. The problem entered his financial life, entered his business, his career, entered his health, entered his family, entered everywhere. And he was just looking at them. Said, it's not your fault. The other guy is saying that when a big trouble floods a person, what will happen? The small one will be walking up. Small one that you know it will come near you before. They will be running their mouth. And Job says something. In the book of, I think Job 16. Job 16, 1 to 3. Job 16. 1, okay, you can even read up to 5. Then Job answered and said, I have heard many such things. Miserable comforters are you. Did you come to comfort me or you came to insult me? That's what he was trying to say. You're a miserable comfort. Shall vain words have an end? Or what emboldeneth thee that thou answerest? I also could speak as you do. If your soul were in my soul's stead, and if you are going to what I'm going to, I could whip up words against you and shake my head at you, pity you. But if I were you, I would not do what you are doing. I would not be stating what you, I would be encouraging you instead of pointing insults at me. But I would strengthen you with my mouth. And the moving of my lips will assuage your grief. Job must have felt so bad. Insults. And he knew that he did not do anything that they were insinuating. That are you sure that it's not because something that you have done that has brought you to this situation? That's why in the book of Job chapter 15, verse 1, Job 30, verse 1, he looked at everything that happened to him. He said that some people, when I was wealthy, that they cannot match with my dogs. They are the one running their mouth. Insults. But now, they that are younger than I have me in derision, whose fathers I would have disdained to have set with the dogs of my flock. He just pitied himself. Insults. It is painful when the result that is coming to your life cannot match the effort that you are putting into life. Painful. It is painful for somebody that has studied very hard to be coming out with a poor result. The result is lying to the world and making the world tag the person wrongly. Painful. In fact, Jesus Christ once upon a time said in the book of Luke chapter 4, 23, Luke 4, 23, you know, in that Luke 4, 16, when he read 16, that was the first time he read that all the eyes were upon him when he read the book in the synagogue, and the Bible said all eyes were fasting upon him. But when he got to verse 20, the way you are celebrating me now, there will come a time that you will say, physician, heal yourself. You cannot see, I know there will come a time. And, no, 23, Luke 4, 23. And he said unto them, ye will surely say unto me, this proverb, physician, heal thyself. Whatsoever we have heard done in Capernaum, do also here in thy country. And when you read the book of Matthew, chapter 26 down, you will see where this scripture came to reality. He said that if you are the Son of God, come down. In fact, two thieves were beside him. They too, they were running their own mouth. Just like I just remember Job's case too. Sometimes insults could be coming. And it could be painful because you feel that I don't think I deserve what I am getting. Insult that I'm getting because I am trying my best, but my result is lying to the world that I'm not trying. You know what happened to Job at the end of the day? In Job chapter 42 verse 10, Job 42 verse 10, God turned his what? His captivity around, and he now had great results. Everyone now came to bow to his results. Can I prophesy into his life? In every area you have been experiencing insults, let the power of God, by the result, good result that will be coming from now on, cancel those insults. And cause all those insulting you, whether in their heart or in secret or openly, to come and bow to your results. Open your mouth and say, Father, by good result that will be coming into my life from now on, cancel every insult. Every insult. People that ought not to even be able to talk to you, they will be talking to you, asking you questions, silly questions sometimes. Turn every insult to great results in my life. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You know, Jesus Christ, by the time, and you know what, Jesus Christ did not come down from the cross. The two thieves, well, especially one of them, he said that if you are the Son of God, save yourself and save us. But he didn't come down. But you know what, by the time the result came by the reason of his ascension, his resurrection. When you read the book of Philippians chapter 2, 9 to 11, Philippians 2, 9 to 11, the Bible says that because he submitted himself to the death on the cross, God now gave him a name. By the reason of that name, what will happen? Every knee. That means that including all those people that have been giving him insult, they must bow. Their father, their children, they must bow unto him. I'm decreeing into your life that by the reason of this anointing that is flowing into your spirit as this word is coming out, let good result be emanating in your life. Yeah. Every insult that you might have been giving or you are still being given, let good results terminate them. Yeah. So shall it be. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. There was a particular couple married for years, trusting God for the fruit of the womb. But the family, not really, they didn't care. They just told the son, I beg, marry another person. And the kind of guy that he did not really have, he didn't have much say. So, after a while, they now got a village girl to bring for him. And they came, like you are much, the uncles, aunties, and some people, they said that we are going to send this woman away. Because over these years now, she has not been brought forth. And let's bring another wife for our son. And the day they actually came, they met the woman. And the woman said, welcome, keep your welcome to yourself. We are giving you an order, a standing order now. The other one was not even around that time. To go inside the house and pack all your load because we have brought a wife for our son. And he said, okay, no problem. She went inside. By the time she came out with an envelope, brown envelope, with white paper inside, and gave to the head of the delegate, one advanced uncle like that, that, sir, please, have this. What for what? I know that you can read. Please read it. And that one opened it. By the time he opened it, it was a lab result, pregnancy result, and showed that she was 3 months pregnant. Is that okay? Who cannot fake all these things? I beg, this is the lie. Ah, no. He said, okay, we will take you to the lab that we want to use. We know that they cannot fake. They went there. The same results they gave to them. And all of them, they now look at the girl. They said, you this girl, you don't know that you are free. You want to come and scatter the house of our son? Money. They don't have no dividend. Don't come and scatter the house of our son. You have to go back home. This is not your own now. Go and look for your own owner. I decree every insult in your life, the result you need in that area to silence the insult, to cancel the insult, let God release unto you. In the name of Jesus. Very important. That thing that can cancel insult, when God, you have a divine encounter. What you are doing now is you are having a divine encounter. In the book of Luke chapter 5, when you read from 1 to 8 self, but we are not reading. Peter had gone to fish. He toiled all night, according to him, in verse 4 and 5. Verses 4 and 5. And how many did he catch? He caught nothing. Insult. Because we will not go home. By the time we go, the children will go, Papa, Oyoyo, Papa, Oyoyo, fish, no fish. Disappointment. That was why he did not go home on time. He had already told us that we will go home. He just stayed there. Was thinking, what will I tell them at home now? Anybody that you have not been able to appropriately answer the people that have been asking you questions, whether wise question or foolish question, the Almighty God on your behalf will answer those questions. By the result, good result that will be emanating from you, those questions shall be answered. But Jesus Christ came on board, and Jesus Christ is coming into somebody's life afresh. Amen. And Jesus Christ, through that encounter, he did not just have small results. The Bible says that his net broke, and he had to call partners. It was outstanding. There is somebody here within now 15 days. A breakthrough that only you cannot gather into your life in the quantum of the evidence of that breakthrough. Let that breakthrough come your way. The breakthrough that you will need laborers to help you to wreck in different ways, let God release your way. In the name of Jesus. And by the time he came, he now became employer of labor. He was now subcontracting. Oh my God, there's somebody, you are in the realm of the contract of businesses, and you have not, business have not been moving, but after this particular divine encounter will appear to be as if it is a simple service, you are going to be having extraordinary breakthroughs done. In the name of Jesus. When you have a divine encounter, little effort you put into life will be bringing great results. See all the effort, toiling all night, I don't know how many minutes it was that Jesus Christ said, launch out into the deep. And he did. I don't know how many minutes. But I don't think it can be compared to, we have toiled all night. When you have a divine encounter with him, little things you will be doing will be making it up. Little words you will speak will be making great impacts. I'm decreeing into your life again. By the reason of this divine encounter that you are having, every insult the one that you have gotten, the one that you are getting right now, and the one that may be planning to come, all of them shall be silenced. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There was a particular soldier man, a born-again Christian soldier, and they used to make jest of him. You know, the colleagues, you try to preach to them, they said, don't preach to us. They were always, anytime he did something that was somehow, everybody would laugh. So they used to pick on him every time. And their commander now wanted to have fun with him that day too. And the other people they knew, he could not drive this particular military truck. And he said, you so, go and move that truck from that place to the end of that road. All of them, he said, I would love to be. They knew he could not drive. And he could not drive that particular truck. And, you know, he obeyed the last order. And he went there as he was doing his heart was beating. He said, why again? Why are these people always picking on me? By the time he entered, he just said, Lord, please help me. I don't even know what to do in this complicated kind of truck. And as he prayed that prayer, God has heard. He did not know. He just entered. As he entered, he just prayed. Anything that he was doing was making sense. And if the vehicle was moving, they just opened their mouth. Moving, and he got to the spot. And he stopped. Thank you, Jesus. He now came down. And he came down, he was coming. He now saw that all of them were on their knees. I was the one thing, what happened? I've been preaching to these people all this. They say, come and pray for us. Come and pray for us. I've been preaching to these people over how many months, years. They don't even want to hear anything like that, even though I kept on. And their commander himself was with tears. What happened? What did I do? Wow. He could not understand. And they said that, he now said, I know now that you serve a living God. Number one, it was a plan to insult you and to make jest of you. We know that you can't drive that particular truck. Number two, the engine of that truck had been removed yesterday. You are not aware. So we just wanted you to fool yourself. How that truck now moved from this place to that place? And we are aware, no engine there, we're just waiting to make sense of it. You don't know that day. And we now started seeing truck moving, and now got to a place.
Awesome.
Miracle happened. Two miracles. That you drove it, and that a vehicle with that engine actually move. For God wanted to prove something to us. And we are ready to accept your Jesus. I decree into your life that any area that you have been insulted, that you don't even know what to say again, let the Almighty God show up with great result.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Very important. I told her when we were in secondary school, there used to be one guy in my class. He was a good, average guy, you know. But one particular class assessment, I don't know, he was just on serious that period, maybe. And this, our principal, when he joined us, he started doing continuous assessment, calling it out in the assembly so that everybody will hear the first five and the last three. So he used that as a sort of motivation. You will not want your name to be mentioned in the whole school above the last three. And some people want their names to be mentioned among the top people in their own class. There are some people who used to hear their name every time in last three. So it's not no big deal. He said, no man. So it's no man. And there are some people used to hear their name among the four. But this guy, he was just average. You never heard his name. But he used to be one of the boys that used to do guy. And they now said, talk to the lads, because that's how the sprinter was saying, talk to the lads. They mentioned one guy's name, Norman. Some people are laughing. They said, come to the lab. They mentioned one another guy's name. That one, we know that he used to come there once in a while. Last, we were not expecting that it would be this guy. No one to mention him so that on the internet that everybody is joking. He said that you are using me to preach this to your church. So he just mentioned this guy's name. And that would be a very popular guy in everybody. Hey! He said, wasn't that class? If you will see that reality of somebody hoping that the ground will open. You know, when you are not supposed to be there, people were just looking at it. And you know, some people now use that opportunity. Maybe they are making jest of it. We saw saying in Daniel, it was that to him, I believe that. I don't know if it's allowed to be me. I will come back to I cannot survive to it. But you know what he was? I was surviving. He didn't want people to see him. They don't see him. Then the next continuous assessment, he said that now the last three, they call the name, the second to the last, fourth, the last three. His name was on. They said, thank God, this guy has come back to his normal average something. Then they call the fifth in that class, the clap. Fourth in that class, third, second. By the time they call, in fact, it's not like this. And the first, he adjusted the guy. He could not believe. And the first, they were just shouting, talking about who is the first. And he now called the guy's name. The whole assembly scattered. Come and see. Whether Babylon or not, everybody started praising this guy. Some people carried, I think we're doing Superman. Then some people carried. I started carrying around the assembly. Hey, we don't. The teacher said, you people stop. Assembly ended. No more, nobody could control anybody. The preacher said, well, let everybody go to the class. Result, good result. Council in assessing about the name. In this room. Because God has given him good results. There is somebody here in a particular area that you are being ashamed, but you don't even know the right word to say. I decree that good result is showing up in that area. I say good result is showing up in that area. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, arise, settle me with good result in every area of my life. Said to me with good result. Thank you, Lord. We'll be praying from that point that I put it. But I didn't send it to them because of the screen, but I'll be praying it from my phone. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. God said, I've removed the teeth from the devouring lion's mouth. From the devouring lion. I don't know whether in your sector, God has removed the teeth. It can only roar, but cannot hurt you anymore. Open your mouth and say, Father, thank you for all that you have done in my life thus far. I am grateful. Receive all the glory. That's the first prayer point. Thank you for all that you have done in my life thus far. I am grateful. Receive all the glory. Receive all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please forgive me of all unrighteousness. That will not my prayer for me and Sam now, in the name of Jesus. forgive me of any right, the one that I know, the one I'm not aware of, that could hinder my prayer from being answered. Please forgive me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Prayer point number 3, say, Father, please divide it on around. Every situation bringing concern and dissatisfaction to me, to a joyful one with wonderful results. Divine it turn around, every situation bringing concern and dissatisfaction to me, turn around to the one with wonderful results emanating there. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please disgrace every situation, person, power, working to disgrace me in the name of Jesus. Disgrace every situation, person, power, working very hard to disgrace me. Let them be disgraced. Let there be a backfire of the disgrace. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 5, say, Father, please turn every reproach in my life to my object of sweet testimonies. Turn every reproach in my life to my object of sweet testimonies. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 6, say, Father, please disappoint all that are waiting to hear or see the continuation of all unpleasant story in my life with major breakthrough in that area of my life. Disappoint all those are waiting to hear or see my whole story continuing. Disappoint them with glorious results that I will be bringing forth from now on in that particular area of my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 7, say, Father, please paralyze all powers assigned or militating against me in any area of my needs and expectation, and urgently settle me gloriously. Paralyze all powers assigned or militating against me in any area of my needs and urgently settle me gloriously in those areas of my need. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 8, say, Father, please cut every mouth that has spoken negatively against me to start speaking positively and favorably due to your wonderful workings in my life. Cut every mouth that has spoken negatively against me. Let them start speaking positively by the reason of your wonderful workings in my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 9, say, Father, please disconnect me from destructive association that will prevent me from getting all your blessings for me this year in the name of Jesus. Disconnect me from all negative association that will prevent me from getting all your blessings you have earmarked for me this year. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father, please touch the hearts of all the people that have my blessings in their custody to say or do what is necessary for them for those blessings to be received by me. Touch the heart of all the people that have my blessings in their custody to say what they need to say, do what they need to do for those blessings to come to me. Touch their hearts. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 11, say, Father, please do marvelous miracles in my life that will help me to catch up and make up for the lost times and lost opportunities in my life. Do miracles in my life that will make me to catch up and make up for lost times, lost opportunities. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Number 12, say, Father, please let all that must be done be done for me to enter into my rest on all areas of my life this year. Everything that will be done, let it be done for me to enter into my rest this year. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Number 13. Say, Father, please help me. Every member of my family and friends to make heaven glorious and with ease in the fullness of our time. Cover the prayer with the blood of Jesus. Cover the prayer with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, we commit the Holy Ghost Congress into your hand. Let there be abundance of every good thing. Let every need be met. Let all sieges be made over. Break every satanic stronghold through the Congress and anoint our Father and other ministers. In the name of Jesus Christ, mightily in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
I want you to please lift up both hands in just about 30 seconds. God said, as you tell us, that is a symbol of you winning and standing.
Yeah.
That from today, in that area, that you have not been winning, that you have not been having mouth, open mouth, with joy to speak in that area, he has just given you victory.
Yeah.
Spirit of the living God, confirm the word that has been spoken.
Yeah.
And let there be immediate results.
Yeah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's pray for our hand to our Father in the Lord. Let's pray for him. Bible says in that water shall be water. Let's pray for him that result that cancel insult, result that cancel insult will be manifest in his life, in his ministry, in his family, in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let's put our hands into our pocket and bring out something to do to bless the name of the Lord. Sky world.
I wanna thank you. Oh my God. I wanna thank you. Oh my God. What a wonderful things you have done for me. Yeah. What a wonderful things you have done for me. Yeah.
Lord, I want to thank you. Thank you for the wonderful things you have done for us. So out of the abundance you've given unto us, we brought this little. Father, we pray that you accept us, accept our offering in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And you bless this offering and multiply it unto us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, dear Lord, for answered prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Please let's have a seat as we listen to the following announcement. Tomorrow, 20th of November, is Family Fun Day, and the title is Jubilation. I thought somebody was going to speak. Tomorrow is Jubilation. Let somebody shout hallelujah. They are not hearing you at the last bus stop, investor. Tomorrow is Jubilation. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Tomorrow is our Family Fun Day 9, and the theme is Jubilation. We're going to be starting 5:30 a.m. We'll converge here for prayer walk. We are going to walk the length and breadth of Festac. Okay, so you are going to do your part. Someone else is going to do his or her part. So together we will walk the length and the breadth of Festac. We are going to shake Festac for Jesus. If somebody is excited, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the name of the Lord. So we'll convert here 5:30. Our takeoff time is 6 a.m. Takeoff time is 6 a.m. So plan to be there. Sleep on time. Get your things ready, your clothes, your shoes. 5:30 6:30 you're out of the house. 6 by 6 you're already here. We'll be waiting to go. 11 a.m. jubilation starts proper. Jubilation starts proper in your life, in your family, in your career, in every area of your life in the name of Jesus. Right, so for the events, there will be snooker, there will be table tennis, there will be board soccer, there will be board games, giant chess. Every year it is going to be loaded. I can assure you. There's going to be about 12 fun tomorrow, and it's going to be glorious. Tell your neighbor, glorious.
Glorious.
So if your neighbor is not in church this evening, tell them that tomorrow is going to be fantastic and glorious. In the name of Jesus. Christmas party. Christmas party comes up December 12th. We are appealing to our mommies, daddies, aunties to support us. God bless us all in Jesus' name.
God bless us all in Jesus' mighty name. If you know that you are going to be around tomorrow and you are going to be representing Nigeria, shout hallelujah. Let's come. It's going to be a fun day from the morning, early morning, up to the time that we'll be having. Just ensure that everything will be alright. No, we'll snap pictures together. They pray different games that you can play, and if it's your own, is to look, don't be going around and be looking and be supporting the people that are playing. Father, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God said, I should tell somebody, regardless of what I've been playing, I am still with you.
Yeah.
Everlasting Father, we appreciate you for all that you have done. We cannot quantify that which you have done. We don't even know all that you have done, but we know you have done so much, and we are glad. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, let there be quick manifestation of all that you have done.
Amen.
We that are here and our brethren that are online, and the one that we yet connect to read it, to watch the recorded part of this ministration, let your power not diminish.
Amen.
In addressing our issue.
Amen.
That person that came to this place with every heart, Father, because you have already granted the person's spiritual result, let it translate to the physical world. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, the goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Salute to the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, our maker, our helper, the one that is going to cause us to jubilate continually, in the name of God the Father,
Amen.
In the name of God the Son,
Amen.
And in the name of God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
K-R-P,
we move.